So in this video lecture, we'll perform the static analysis to our space frame that we modeled in our previous video lecture. So as per EDAP's checklist, in this video lecture, we'll complete these two steps, that is step number 10 and step number 11. So the step number 10 is nothing but the defined analysis options, in which we will assign the meshing to our frames. We'll check the model again, because after applying the mesh and assigning the loads, we need to check the model again for any modeling errors with respect to the meshing and the loading. And after that, we need to check the active degree of freedom to the structure, and then we need to set the load cases to run. And after that, we'll auto relabel all the frame sections in the space frame, so that after analysis and design, we'll get the name of the each structural section in a linear way. And after that, we'll set the advanced SAF fire options, and in the way we'll define all the analysis options. So let's get started to this step 10. So first of all, let's assign the meshing to our frame sections. So let me first of all click on undeformed shape. So now go to assign, go to frames. So here only the frame sections we model, that are nothing but the steel sections. So for that, go to frame auto mesh options. So now here we have two options under the mesh options, that is no auto meshing and auto meshing frame objects. So I will go with the auto meshing frame objects. And here for the auto meshing frame objects, the mesh at intermediate joints is selected, and mesh at intersection with other frames and area edges is also selected. So I will go with this default menu. And now we need to select the whole structure. So by dragging the cursor, I have selected here the whole structure, and now click on apply. Now here you can see the meshing to our frame sections are now applied. Now click on OK. So here in the way the meshing is applied to our structure. So now here for our space frame structure, the meshing for the all frame sections are applied. So in our model, we have here applied the loads also and apply the meshing also. So now we need to check our model with respect to the loading and meshing. So for that, go to analyze and click on check model. Previously, as we check our structure for joint checks and frame checks, now we need to check our structure for meshing and loading. Whereas these checks, that is shell checks and duplicate self mass check, that we did not need to consider as per our structure. Click on the fixes, that is check for the fix, that is fix for the trim or extend frames and to move joints to fix the problems and joint story assignment. Now click on OK. Now ETAPS will check our model. So here we have got the message that model has been checked and no warning message is generated. That means there is no any error in our model with respect to the loading, with respect to the meshing, and also with respect to the modeling. So close this window. Now we need to check the active degree of freedom for our structure. So for that, go to analyze and click on set active degree of freedoms. So here our structure is full 3D structure. So make sure that the active degree of freedom is full 3D. And click on OK. So here in the analysis, we want to run all the load cases. So to check that, go to analysis and left click on the set load cases to run. So here you can see for all the load cases, here the action is run, which it means when we start our analysis, all the load cases will be run. So click on OK. Now let's auto relabel all the structural elements, so that what happened? If I right click on these element and check here the label, so the label number is here B3, whereas for these is B7. So this is what non-linear. Now let's auto relabel all these structural elements in our space frame, so that the names to our structural sections as the label name, which is the unique name as per the software for each structural section in the space frame, will be assigned in a linear way. Whereas till now the label names are assigned as we draw our structure. So to auto relabel all the structural sections, go to edit and click on auto relabel all. So here you can see this window will open, and here it is a message that relabeling cannot be undone. Do you want to relabel? Yes. Click on yes. And yes, here it is, the all structural sections are now auto relabel. So now the names to the structural sections are assigned in a linear way. As here you can see, now let me show you. This is B1. This is a B2. This is a B3. And this will become the B4. So in the linear way, the names are assigned to the frame sections. This is what the use of auto relabeling. That makes the all structural sections gives the label as in a linear way. Click on 3D view and click on this undeformed shape. Now we need to define the advanced sapphire options. If you are advanced user of the softwares from the CSI company, that is softwares like eTabs, SAP, SAFE, CSI Bridge, then you might know about this option, which is under the option analyze. So here we have the option advanced sapphire options. So here you can see the different solver options and the analysis process options under the advanced sapphire options. So behind the eTab software, there is a SAP engine that works the analysis. So here for solver options, here we have three options. So the standard solver is for the best for the structural stability checks and good for problem size. Whereas advanced sapphire option is better for structural stability checks, best for problem size and better for solution speed. Advanced sapphire option is default by the eTab software, whereas the multi-threaded solver is good for structural stability checks, better for problem size and best for solution speed. For the standard solver, it may require the more time, but I should recommend everyone, whenever you do the first analysis to your structure, at that time you should go with the standard solver, because it takes time but it gives you the complete report in the analysis run log. And the here we have different options, that is analysis process options, that is auto, GUI process and the separate process. Auto is the automatic process which can be made as per your structure automatically by the software. GUI process is better for the small problems and the separate process is better for the large problems. So here I will go with the auto, whereas our structure is a small structure, we can also go with the GUI process, but here I am going with the auto. So left click on OK. So here in the way we have also defined the advanced sapphire options. So here all the analysis options are defined. In the way here we have completed the step 10, in which we first of all assign the meshing, then we check the model, and after that we'll check the active degree of freedom, then we set the load cases to run. Then we make a change to auto relabel all for the all structural sections in our space frame, and we also set the advanced sapphire options. So here in the way, step 10 is completed. Now let's move on to the step 11, that is the analyze the structure and check the behavior. So the first step under the step 11 is analyze the model by run analysis. So to analyze the model, go to analyze and click on run analysis. Whereas here you can see the status of analysis. So the structure is now analyzed by the software. So the first step after analysis is to check the last analysis run log. So for that, go to analyze and click on last analysis run log. Double click on this window to maximize the window. So here we have the complete report of analysis of our space frame. So here we have on the top the details of the software and the location of the file. So here you can see the begin analysis, the all the number of joints, mass, restraints are here noted. So the most important thing that we need to check in this analysis run log is that the basic stability check for the linear load cases. So here you can see the basic stability check for the linear load cases is okay, which it means the model which is analyzed by the software, it's stable, which is not running into any instability. If there is any instability in a model, then it will be shown here, and to resolve that error we need to unlock the model and made the changes to satisfy the condition to get the basic stability check should be okay. So for a validation, I always used to take a copy of these analysis run log. Now let me show you how to take this copy of these analysis run log. First of all, close this window and open the folder where the model is saved. Here I have saved my model in this folder, that is space frame 25 by 25 as per American standards. So here, number of different types of files are generated by the software for one single model. So here we have this text document, which is space frame 25 by 25 as per American standards. So open this document. So here you can see this is the analysis run log. So for the validation of analysis, I always take a PDF file of this text file. Go to file and click on print. So here under the option select printer, we have here option available to save your text document as a PDF, that is a Microsoft print to PDF. But I always use to save the PDF by using the Adobe PDF. So here I'm go with the Adobe PDF. If you don't have the softwares like Adobe Acrobat Pro DC or Bluebeam, which are paid softwares, then you can simply go with the Microsoft print to PDF. So in the way you can also save your text file to the PDF. So here I'm go with Adobe PDF and click on apply. Click on print and give the name as analysis run log and click on save. So here you can see now Adobe will generate the PDF file of this text document. So here you can see this file, that is analysis run log. So what I do after generating the PDF of the last analysis run log, I always use to highlight this section, that is the basic stability check, like this. So now you can see the basic stability check for the linear load cases. So the check is now highlighted. So the things like this are done in the consultancies to check the work by the junior designers or to save the documents for the validation. And for the quick review, these highlights are made. If you don't have the paid softwares like Adobe Acrobat Pro DC or Bluebeam, you can also go for the free softwares which highlights the PDF. That also helps. So now I will save this PDF. So now this highlighted part will be saved. Come back to the eTabs. So here you can see the software completes the analysis of a space frame. Now what we need to do, first of all we need to check the deflections. So for that, go to display and click on deform shape. So check the deflection for general load combinations and the load cases. So before checking the deflections for a particular load combination, you should know for what load combination you are checking the deflections. So to know which load combination is which, so for that go to define and click on load combinations. So here we have strength based and deflection based load combinations. So strength based are nothing but the design load combinations. So S1 is DL 1.4 and SIDL 1.4 scale factor, whereas S2 is the scale factors for the dead load and superimposed dead load are 1.2 and the for live load it is 1.6. So this is also very important load combination that we need to check. So S1, S2 and D1. D1 is nothing but the one with dead load and superimposed dead load scale factor. So also we need to check the load combination with the lateral loading. That is, here you can see the strength based load combination S7, that is for dead load with 0.9 and wind load with 1 scale factor. So 7 should be also considered. And load combination 11, which is the load combination of the earthquake load in the X direction. So for here in this load combination, for the live load and earthquake load, the scale factor is 1, and for dead load and superimposed dead load, the scale factor is 1.3. Click on OK. So we need to check the maximum deflections for these important load combinations, that is D1, S1, S2, S7 and S11. So click on OK. So click on the combo and first of all we'll go with the S1 and click on apply. So now for this combination, the deflections at each joint will be shown if we move the cursor over the joints. But to see results in the faster manner, here you can see the maximum and minimum deflections. So here you can see the maximum deflection is 4.215 mm, which is too less. Now let's again see the next load combination, that is S2. Click on apply. So maximum displacement for this S2 load combination is 7.295 for our model. Now let's check for the S7. Here I am not checking for all load combinations because we have here symmetric structure. There is no meaning, you just need to check for the one direction because our loading and the structure symmetry is same. So here I am only checking the S7 for the wind and S11 for the earthquake. S7 applied here. So here you can see the maximum deflection is 2.77 mm. Also we need to check for the S11. Click on apply, and here you can see for the load combination with dead load, live load and earthquake load, the maximum deflection is 6.223 mm, so which was also too less. Also we need to check the deflection for the serviceability load combination, that is D1 and D2. Click on apply. So here you can see for the first serviceability load combination, that is one for dead load and live load, maximum deflection is 3.011 mm, and for another serviceability load combination which is from deflection point of view, apply. Here you can see the maximum deflection is 5.312 mm, which is too less, so it is okay. So under the case, we also need to check the deflections for the lateral loads such as WL. So here you can see for the positive wind in the X direction, which it means this is the X direction. So whenever the wind load will be act, the displacement will be like this, and the maximum displacement will be 0.156 mm at the 19.5 meter from the X axis, 12.5 meter which is mid of the space frame, in the Y direction, and the one which it means at the top. So at the top, in the mid, in the X direction from the 19.5 meter, the maximum displacement will be 0.146 mm, which is also too less. So also see the displacements for earthquake load. So here you can see the maximum displacement is 0.018 mm, which is also too less. If you are using the heavy steel structural sections, then you also need to check the deflections for the dead load load case. So here I will go with the dead load, and here you can see the maximum deflection 1.093 mm, which is also too less. So click on OK. So here we get that the displacement values are too less, which are in a considerable limit. So it is OK. Now let's see the analysis results, that are nothing but axial forces, shear forces and the bending moments. So for that, go to display, click on force stress diagrams and click on frame pier spandrel link forces. First of all, let's see the axial forces, which are the most dominant one for the load combination S1, that is strength point of view. Click on apply. So here you can see at the mid, the axial forces are higher as compared to the axial forces in the sides. So here you can also see that the in the diagonal elements, because of these load combination, that is S1, in which only dead load is considered. So in that case, here you can see in the diagonal elements, there is no any major force, only 2.5 kN like forces, which is too less as compared to this top and bottom forces. In the top member, here you can see 114.5 kN force. So as compared to the diagonal elements, the at the top the forces are too high, and in the bottom at mid, here you can see the maximum forces are 37.27 kN. So this is the reason I have provided the large sizes at the top and bottom of the space frame, whereas the small sizes at the diagonal elements. So for the S1 load combination, which it means for the dead loads, here you can see that at the mid, the axial forces are higher as compared to the outer side of the space frame. Whereas for the S2 load combination, also the same thing, because in S2 load combination also the dead loads and live loads are present, which both are the gravity loads. So in that case, the behavior will be same, because the behavior depends upon the type of the pattern of the load. Now let's check the behavior for the S7 load combination. Click on apply. So here you can see for the S7, the axial forces are also maximum at the mid, but for the S7 is the load combination for the wind load in the positive X direction. So because of these load combination, here you can see in the mid sections of the space frame have the axial forces higher as compared to the members which are at the corner section of the space frame. So this is the change or behavior we can say. And let's see for the S11 in which the earthquake load is considered with respect to the dead load and live load. Click on apply. So in this case you can see the behavior is somewhat critical as compared to the wind load combination. The forces are higher at the mid as compared to the corner elements, whereas at the mid the forces are too high. Now let's see the axial forces for the serviceability load combination, which is one scale factor. So the same case as the case for the S1 load combination. So now let's see the shear forces and moments. So let's see first of all shear forces. So S22, that is a major shear. So here you can see the shear forces which are for the D1, that is serviceability load combination. So here you can see in the case of shear forces, the shear forces has the some kind of value which was in axial forces was somewhat negligible as compared to the forces in the top and bottom structural sections. So these shear forces and the moments, that is M33, that is a major moment, here you can see that makes a difference between the space frame and the plane frame. So in the case of moment, here you can see the positive moments are at mid of the space frame and the negative moments are at the outer side of the space frame. When you first time design the space frame structure, so for the basic understanding I should recommend you to go with the each and every load combination and each and every load case for the different types of forces, so that you will get to understand what exactly the behavior under the different types of forces. Now left click on OK and click on this undeformed shape. So here we have successfully analyzed our structure by the static analysis, and we have also seen the behavior of structure, which is primarily okay because this is the general case in the case of the space frame structures. So here in the way we have completed these two steps, that is analyze the model by run analysis and check the analysis run log to check the model which does not run into the instability, and also we have checked the behavior of structure. So in the way step 11 is completed. In the next video lecture, we'll see the step 12, that is the design of the space frame structure.